Without further ado, I want to welcome the next moderator, who is Genevieve Sabala. Genevieve is a professor at the University of Wisconsin-Stout. Genevieve, please.
Thank you very much, Basil. And today it seems like we are really running. I'm from Kenya. I run a little bit, but not a marathon. And today being the first day, I think we, even though we are running a little bit late, I think we'll make it to the finish line successfully. So for this next session, I'm honored to introduce our next panelists. The first topic that Badru Hassan Seguja, a senior lecturer for international relations and diplomacy, peace and conflict resolution, is going to speak on traditional practices and conflict de-escalation in East Africa.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. We welcome you to East Africa. This is about traditional practices and conflict de-escalation in the East African community. The East African community is under the Great Lakes region and definitely within the African continent. And this area has suffered a number of intractable conflicts where at the same time, as I'm speaking, so many are still planning to kill their brothers and friends somewhere in southern Sudan. These communities suffer too much in the post-colonial regime as compared to the colonial period, yet under the leadership of their own brothers and neighbors who are ready to take over their families. The region is made up of six countries. That is Uganda, Kenya, Tanzania, Rwanda, Burundi, and Southern Sudan. Fortunately, for the first time for ICRM, we thank you so much for inviting and being able to receive a number of participants from the same East African community. So these have experienced a number of conflicts, some of which are internally caused and others due to external factors, but they all lead to loss of human life, dignity, and property. The conflicts within this area change shapes depending on the designer. They would first range through institutional, peaceful, and violent protests. They move to freedom struggles and demonstrations against human rights abuses, and after which the participants move into the bush and take over the gun to control up to the final destination. Where we have ethnicity as a common East African identity, this has not been given a chance, though East Africans have been and were privileged to have a common identity where principles of collective responsibility and communal solidarity were at the forefront or in the conflict de-escalation. These were the ones that can support, and they have been supported by traditional dressing, traditional ceremonies, language, and cultural dressing. East Africans have a variety of ethnic groups that can be easily understood in different ways. Societies can be understood due to the nature of dressing. They can be understood due to a nature of traditional ceremonies. And definitely, on the other hand, they have a number of languages that lead to someone's understanding that this one belongs to the other ethnic group. However, these have not been given value. Even where we have religion that can be a rallying point towards peace or conflict resolution, as it has been in the Northern Ireland, in the conflicts that came on an international agenda, the East Africans have not utilized their religions well in order to bring to bring their communities together. As East Africans would be managing conflicts in a number of areas, we have a number of issues that can be raised here, such that we know where is the problem coming from. We have the first stage is the pre-colonial era. This one, the East Africans were successfully managing the resolution agenda within their communities. Then the colonial era provided a good direction, but wrong societies, simply because societies were not sensitized and we are not ready for the colonial rule. And on the other hand, the post-colonial era lost somewhere where people became confused and societies were left at crossroads, meaning that the agenda for the conflict de-escalation within the East African communities started at a point where people remained at crossroads, not going back to the post-colonial, to the pre-colonial era. Yet they have to move forward, but they do not have a direction. So we may expect that where we have families, something can be done, but traditional practices that have to play a great role in building up people's mutual understanding or creating mutual institutions, marital institutions that were done in the pre-colonial era or the post-colonial era, where marriage was concluded at a stage of cultural activities, all these are broken institutions. And the question remains, what went wrong? This study employed a descriptive correlation and qualitative research design where purposive and simple random sampling were employed as the youth's traditional leaders and the religious institutions came into force. So the findings were that the use of force to manage ethnic violence has not brought any good. Whenever there is a conflict, whether social or political, and the use of force comes in, this one leads to a conflict to escalate. Yet there is need for conflict to calm down when we use other means rather than force. Secondly, the international peacekeeping missions and Africa's ethnic conflict managers are not guided with ethnic values. The international peacekeeping mission, the African peacekeeping managers, especially from the traditional and the ethnic groups, need guidance in as far as traditional values are concerned. Thirdly, a direct relationship between conflict and poverty has been realized, that whenever there is conflict, expect poverty. And whenever there is poverty, expect violence. And the cycle is moving on and on. The influence of traditional practices in conflict de-escalation was found as a missing component in some societies. Then traditional practices are needed in African societies as they lead to peaceful coexistence. As far as peace is concerned, there is need for practices to come to be put in place. People should celebrate the ceremonies within their different cultures. Languages must be encouraged, and the dressing code should be at its maximum in order to register peace and conflict de-escalation. Conclusion, the study concludes that traditional practices significantly influence people's perceptions at a moderate and high level based on age, social status, and gender factors, though with religious affiliations. And the study recommends that African politicians, religious leaders, and traditional leaders should put these practices together much more value than ever before in case we want to retain our glory, which is peace. And this can be done by encouraging traditional ceremonies, languages, and cultural dressing. Thank you. Together for peace.